had before you were drawing for a living. But what have you done? You know, you left school. How did you get where you are now? What job?
You got a pat answer there, Stuart?
Well, I dropped out of university. So I was 18 years old, and at that time there were a lot of, I've told this story a lot this weekend, so it seems very familiar to me that everybody should know already, but there were a lot of comics being published independently in Toronto at that time. There were a lot of comic book creators also living in the city, so I just indulged, you know, my personal interest in comics and translated my brief schooling in fine arts into making a go of it. It just seemed like something that was possible with very little resources. And once I started working in comics and started pursuing work for other publishers, that's basically all I did. I was working for lots and lots of small publishers for about 5 years, and then finally got a toehold in at DC. And that's all I've done. And I don't know, is that a pat answer? That's I got roped into comics early and didn't stop doing them.
I too did not make it through college. I was taking graphic design, and I was asked to leave after the first year. The true story. And I didn't have the nerve to tell my parents that I'd washed out at school. And they were both working at the time, so they'd be up very early on from the house. And I'd spend all day working my butt off, drawing, thinking, I've got to get a job somewhere. And I had a job in a pub, a part-time job as a waiter. And there was a couple that came into the pub almost every evening, and they owned a music magazine that they were publishing out of a little brownstone down the street from the pub. And one night they came in and they were kind of upset because they had lost their art director for the magazine. And I didn't let on, but I can remember going, that's it. And I went home and I took their magazine and it looked quite horrible. So it was very easy for me to sit down, and I spent a week redesigning it, coming up with all kinds of ideas for how I would make it look, and I put together this big presentation for them. And then one night they came into the bar and I said, I'd really like to show you this work that I've put together. I understand you need an art director at the magazine. And they told me to bugger off and leave them alone while they had their pint. And then she said, no, you know what, come by the office tomorrow and we'll take a look. And they hired me. And as we did a panel yesterday, we were talking about, you know, my early career, and a lot of guys, when they're interviewing me, say, you know, you got started so late, it must be horrible for you to have missed out on doing comics for all those years. And it's like, no, I worked at a music magazine for 5 years. You know, I got to meet, well, you name it. I got to meet them, I got to have them photographed, I got to illustrate and design the magazine, and then from there I went to a fashion magazine. So at the age of 27, I was working at a fashion magazine. I'm in the wardrobe room helping Cindy Crawford pick out a top to wear for a photo shoot. And I didn't miss comics at all.
That's
the info. Oh, ridiculous. Yeah. And so, yeah, it's very hard for me to say, wow, yeah, looking back, I squandered my 20s when I could have been doing comics. It's quite the opposite. You know, I got to meet David Bowie and Robert Plant and, you know, Rankin Roger and, you know, all kinds of guys that I was really into. And, you know, you get to work with them for a day or 2 days. And then the fashion work, you know, I think that speaks for itself. It was just making women look beautiful, beautiful clothing. And then finally, one day I did get tired of all this and realized that, you know, what I really wanted to do, what I really, really wanted to do was this. And, you know, I started directing my attention towards it.
Thank you.
I like how your job before was making women look beautiful, and now your job in comics is making women look beautiful, but with as few lines as possible.
That's right. Well, they're both the same, actually.
This is true.